Now here you see two resistors are connected in parallel. R1 and R2 are connected in parallel, and they are common terminal connected to a voltage source of V4. Clear all of you? They are common terminals in parallel connected resistors, okay, connected to a voltage source of V4. We get due to the voltage source V4 a high amount of current going through the parallel combination. Okay? Here, voltage drop across R1 say V1. Okay? Total current going from the source at this junction, some current will flow through resistor R1 and some current flow through resistor R1. So, total current at this junction is I equals to I1 plus I2. Or algebraic sum of current meeting at a junction of conductor 1 is 0, or sum of incoming current must equal to sum of outgoing current. Okay? Now you see, we have already known from the properties of parallel connection that voltage remains the same. Okay? So voltage across resistor R1 equals to voltage across resistor R2, that is the supply. That's why V equals to V1 equals to V2. Okay. And in case of parallel connection, we know warrants are identical. So I equals to I1 plus I2. Okay, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Being voltage remains the same, so V equals to V1. But if we need the supply voltage or applied voltage, applying Ohm's law, we can write that is IRE. Where R is your what? Total resistance or equivalent resistance or net resistance or effective resistances of parallel. Okay. And what is V1? V1 is the voltage drop across resistor R1, which is I1 R1. So IRE equals to I1 R1. So I1 will become IREQ by R1. What is REQ? REQ in case of two resistors connected in parallel, R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay. So, finally you can write I1 equals to total current I into R2 by R1 plus R2. This indicates current flowing through resistor R1 is going to find out that total current flowing through the junction into its opposite or neighboring resistance divided by sum of the resistances of parallel combination. Okay. In this way, you have to find out current to resistor R. Similarly, current to resistor R2 will be I2 will be total current to the junction into wherever you are taking the current, its neighboring or opposite resistance divided by total resistance is of what? Parallel current. Okay. I1, I2. Okay. So, in this way, you have to find out the current to the individual resistor. Okay. Accordingly, if we have a n number of resistors connected in parallel, we can also find the current flow in the resistor.